Hello my beautiful Bitterroots and welcome to my channel, and today I have a quick craft project for you all. This is going to be an $8 Dollar Tree haul slash craft project. This is everything you could buy at the Dollar Tree except for glue gun. I don't know if you could buy glue guns at the Dollar Tree, but you can buy glue sticks at the Dollar Tree. Now, I don't normally suggest you buy glue sticks from the Dollar Tree because this is a cool temp glue gun, but it like literally like leaks glue when you're not using it. I'm not a big fan of these glue sticks. Normally I will go to Joann Fabrics or Michaels and buy my glue sticks from there because those ones I don't feel like I'm not wasting my glue. But in this case, I will do glue sticks from the Dollar Tree. I've got a bunch of them here. And then the other supplies you will need outside of the glue stick is some flowers. I picked up 3 bunches of flowers because I'm doing like a little pink, like a nudie pink like motif for Valentine's and spring and that type of stuff. So I picked up rose flowers. They're super pretty. And I'll show you exactly what I do with these. Then I have like this creamy pink flower. It's the peonies. And then I have another peony, but more of darker pinks. So as you can see, these are the 3 colors that I will be using. I don't know if I'll use all of these flowers. That's a lot of flowers, but I just wanted to show you what I do with flowers because I totally deconstruct them because I do not want any plastic in these flowers whatsoever. I need crystals. You can buy crystals at the Dollar Tree. So I will grab my crystals, my Dollar Tree crystals. You can tell a difference between Dollar Tree crystals and the other ones. But I will grab those in a minute. I grabbed a ring form, a little metal wreath ring at the Dollar Tree. And then I picked up 3 things of ribbon. So I picked up 2 of these burlap ribbon in pink. And then I picked up this really cute plaid ribbon. So as you can see, the color motif and the flowers, they all kind of go and match. So let me go get the crystals too, because we'll need those. So I have this container full of crystals. A lot of these crystals I bought at Joann Fabrics, but I do have some Dollar Tree ones in here. And I will show you the difference between my Joann Fabric crystals versus my Dollar Tree crystals. Okay, so here is a Dollar Tree crystal, this purple one. Is a Dollar Tree crystal. I don't know if you could see that, but the facets aren't as prominent. There's not as many facets, and then it's kind of cloudy. This is a crystal that I bought at Joann Fabrics. I don't know if you can see. This is a big one versus a small one, but here's the big one, and see how many facets there are and how clear it is. This is a Dollar Tree one. Doesn't have as many facets and it's not as clear, but you could still get some pretty cute little crystals. Here are some square ones that you could buy at the Dollar Tree, and then some oval ones. You can get quite a bit of product. Here's a big versus little. The big one is the Joann Fabrics and the little one is the Dollar Tree. So as you can tell that this one is more cloudy, doesn't have as many facets in it, but you know, you can still get some pretty good crystals out of the Dollar Tree. So, with that said, let's just start on with, first of all, I'm gonna pan this down and then I'm gonna show you what I do with the flowers. And what I'll do is I'll fast forward, I'll show you step by step what I do with the flowers, and then we'll fast forward through me working through all of them. A lot of the time I combine like 2 flowers into 1 big giant flower. So I will show you what I do there, and let's get started in this Valentine spring wreath for your decor. So here we go. Sorry, this is kind of a little dirty. So I'm gonna take my first batch of flowers. I'm just gonna pull all the heads off.
And you're just left with this. So with that, let's see how many there are. There's two, three big ones and three little ones. So what I'll do is I'll combine a big one and a little one and make three flowers out of this bunch. So let me put this aside. So first of all, I'm going to just take all these plastic pieces off. Just like so. And then you could start pulling out your flowers. I kind of do it to where I remember the order that they're in. So when I glue them together, I know how it goes. So, and then we're gonna take the small one and do the same thing. So this one is a big one, so we'll put that one there. And then we have this one. Okay, so I take the biggest piece and I take my glue gun. Super easy to do. I think I've showed this process in another video, but I just wanted to show you it again. So I just put a dollop of glue. I kind of just do a circle around that hole. You don't need a whole lot. And then I offset the petals and just put it on and push it down. Do that again. Offset the petals, line it up in the center, push down. The Dollar Tree glue is also very stringy, so you'll have to pull the strings off at the end. So you just keep doing this until you use up all of the flowers. Last one. Okay, so that flower is done. I'm going to take my crystal. I think I'll do a pink crystal in there. Put some glue on it, but not too much glue to where you're going to push down and that glue is going to seep out. So I set it down there and then I just lightly tap until it gets into place. If you push down right away, that glue would ooze out of that crystal and you'll see the glue outside the crystal, and we don't want that. So we just tap it as it's cooling until it's finally into place, and see, there we go. Again, gotta get rid of all of the glue. But here is our first flower. See how pretty that turned out? So I'm gonna go ahead and do the next two out of this one, and then we'll start on the next batch of flowers, so. So that first flower bouquet came out with three really thick, full flowers. And they're super cute. Love the little crystal accent. Makes it really pretty. So let's move on to the next set of flowers. Let's do these white and pink ones. Okay, so there's only five of these flowers. There is one, well, this one's already falling apart. So there's one big one and three or four medium-sized ones. I pulled them out and their little inserts are falling out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this one on its own, and then these ones, these smaller ones, I'm going to combine into one. So we'll have three flowers from this batch too. So let's go on to just putting together the, okay, all of these are all same size. That plastic piece, that one. Just separating out by size. So there we have my three different sizes. I'm gonna start with the biggest size and just start building up our flower again. So I offset like that, but then the next one I'm gonna go at another angle, a different angle there. So then it really fills in this flower. So then I'm gonna go in like this. Where's the hole? I'm gonna go in between the other two flowers. And this one needs to be right there. Next size. You just start, just continue to build up this flower. Now I'm going on to my smaller sizes. Just remember just to offset the petals. It makes it the flower look so much full, more full that way. Pull off the extra stringies because they're everywhere. And then we're going to put a little crystal in the middle. I could go with that one. That bring in, I think I'm gonna go with that. I'm gonna go with these orangey ones because then that'll tie in this color better. Yes, I agree. Good job, Zoma, good job. And once you get your little crystal in there, you can fluff it up and see, there we go, super cute. So I'm gonna do these other two and then I'll get back to you. Flower number two. So here we are with three flowers out of that bouquet. And the last one. We have these ones. Okay, so this one, I was short one flower out of this. So I forgot to count this batch. I thought that I had, this one was missing a flower in this bouquet, but that's all right. We'll just split it up evenly. We'll just have two flowers instead of three flowers. Okay, so I split them up as best as I can. So one flower is going to have only one big one, but one extra of the middle size, and then this one's gonna have one extra big one and one less of this one. I just split it up the best I could, so they'll still look really good. Anyway, but with that said, let's get on to gluing these. I'm gonna put these little squares in the middle of these ones. So that'll pull in what little white that's in this. So there's that one. Let's get this one all glued up. The ones that have the little dots in them, don't worry about them. They're fine. As long as you have them hidden inside the flower, nobody will notice that there's those weird marks in there. So there's these two flowers are completely done. So we have a total of eight flowers all done up, nice and pretty. Okay, so next we're gonna take this ring and I'm gonna take this burlap ribbon and I'm gonna wrap around this wire form to completely cover it up. So this does have a little bit of wire in it. The first fold is always the nicest. I keep that fold in there. And then what I'll do is I will just glue this fold down onto itself. You don't need a whole lot of glue, just enough to stick that together. So after we glue this, we're gonna go through and just wrap maybe like a quarter, overlap it by a quarter of the ribbon size. So that way we make sure that we have enough to wrap. I unwound it from the thing and just kinda bunched it up because it's easier to handle that way than it is to handle the spool itself. It's kind of a pain in the butt. So just hold on to it, wrap, Just make sure you're only wrapping a third of the ribbon size. For this one, this is a 1.5-inch ribbon, 2-inch ribbon. And I'm just going through and I'm just kind of clamping, pushing this down onto the wire itself because there is a little bit of wire in this ribbon. I just want to make sure that it's secure. Okay, so we're going to go, this is going to wrap a little over half of the, so now we're at the halfway mark, but we still have a few more wraps out of this, so that's good. We'll have a little bit of ribbon left over. Good thing I grabbed two. Yeah, we're two wraps over. So not too bad, not too bad. Okay. I'm just gonna cut this shorter. I'm gonna flip it over. I'm gonna fold it in on itself again. Let's glue this quick. You don't need much glue, just remember that. Fold in on itself, and then I'm gonna glue this onto the ribbon again. Okay, and then just hold it. So that way it doesn't go anywhere. So we have most of it wrapped. We just have a little bit more to go. We got about 2/3 of it wrapped. So I will open up this one. So now I am glued right where I left off. Oh, and I'm just gonna continue wrapping. Okay, so now that we're fully wrapped, I'm gonna hold tight to this again and cut. I'm gonna do a big glue spot. Ow, that got my finger. Okay, so here we are. We are completely wrapped. As you can see that there is one spot where it doesn't match up with the rest of the wrapping. That's all right. I normally stick flowers on that. Okay, so then I'm gonna take this little corner and I'm just gonna do like a bunch of flowers just on the kind of the one side. Do a generous amount of glue on this part in the center and then just place it where you would like it and hold tight. If you want the flowers up close, you make sure that you lift up the petal so that way you're not gluing on top of another petal of a flower. Okay. There we go. We have like this little flower motif in here. And if you want to fill in some of these gaps, you can go in and glue like a bigger crystal in there so that way you have like a little pop of flash in there. So I'm actually going to do that. I'm going to glue some crystals down in there just to make it look really pretty. I'm going to do some of these bigger ones. And I'm going to glue this like right in the center of these flowers. I don't know if you can see that, but then you can see down in there and you can get a little crystal in there. You may not even see these down in there, but I don't know. Maybe you might be able to see if there is a little crystal down in there. So if anything does show, you do have like a little pop of color popping through there. So there is that. Now I'm going to make a bow. So I would like a nice big bow. Let's see. I would like to do a big bow like right here. So hopefully I have enough here to do a bow. This one is not okay, hold on. There's an alarm going off at my neighbor's house, so I gotta go check it out.
Okay, so I am so glad I just went out there. I am like all fogged up. But I heard a car alarm, a horn of some sort, and I'm like, something's off. Because it wasn't like the constant beep, beep, beep. It was beep, 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 you know, like crazy. So I put on my boots. I didn't have any socks on. The insoles of my boots were taken out because they need to dry. So I just put on my boots as is, which, by the way, no socks and boots without inserts. Really cold. But I went outside and noticed that my neighbor's car door was open. And so I kind of peeked over. I'm like, that's really strange. And I don't see her anywhere. So I ran over to my neighbor's house. And there she is, sprawled out. She had fallen in the ground, on the ground. And she's my elderly, disabled neighbor. And she was on the ground. And she got herself pulled up into the car enough to honk the horn. So it was interesting trying to get her back up. And thank goodness that our water guy was out there. So I called him over and I'm like, hey, I need help getting her up. Please, can you run over and I need your help. And so he came over and we both, between both of us, got her up on her knees again. She has two artificial knees and so she can't bend them very long. And so she was in a lot of pain. And then of course she broke down and cried because we helped her. She thought she was just gonna die out there. And so I am so glad that I didn't have the TV or music going on, because if I had anything like that going on in the house, I never would have heard her honking her horn. So she was so grateful, and I'm just so happy that she was okay enough to go to her doctor's appointment. That's where she was going. And so very thankful for our friend to come over and help get her up too. That was pretty scary. And she was so worried, and it just broke my heart. But I told her that we love her and that we're always here for her. And so if she needs anything, just call. Because I do worry about her. So with that said, let's go on to making the bow. Now that I have a red nose and red cheeks and frozen fingers and frozen feet. My feet are completely frozen now. But she's safe now. Onto finishing our wreath. So it's looking really pretty so far. All right, so let's go get on to doing the bow. So we have this really beautiful plaid. This does not have wire in it. So I'm going to do my little loops like this. So that basically I just keep taking this and folding it in on each other multiple times until I get the desired look I want for the bow. Do I want to do three or more? Let's do four. Yeah, I'm going to do four bows, four loops on each side. And then what I'm going to do is just kind of fold this together like that, in on its on each other. And then take this and just start wrapping around the middle. Okay, and then I'm going to wrap it around. Glue this down just like so, and then take these bows and just start spreading them out a bit.
So here is my bow. Okay, I'm gonna do the bow right here, but this is probably going to fall off because they normally always do, but I'm just gonna glue this down onto here like so. Okay, and then I'm gonna take a little bit of this strip and I'm gonna wrap it all the way around the whole bow and the thing, just to give it more support so the bow doesn't fall. So I did that, makes the bow look a little more full. There we go, with the little flowers and the bow. So I'm gonna do a little tail on this and I just thread it through that middle piece. I know it's kind of cheating, but I'm going to take this. Singe the end so that way it doesn't unravel. Here we are with the final look of this. I will actually show it what it looks like up on the wall so you guys can see the full look of this product, of this item. And I am going to get another thing of ribbon. Okay, so there's a little bit of this ribbon left over. So what I'm going to do is put these together like so. Kind of, I don't know, not like this, but kind of flip it to where it's got like this nice little loop. I'm gonna glue these two together. Okay. And then on the back side, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue this on the back. Lots of glue. I want this to stay, so I'm gonna cut another piece of ribbon here, like so. And I'm gonna glue this whole big piece on the back of this so that way it holds this ribbon into place. So here we are with the finished product. Here's what the little bow looks like. And then the actual product itself. And I'm gonna go hang this up on the wall and I will show you what it looks like hanging up. So here is my quick little, wanna say, $8 project. Just remember that I'm counting the full pack of glue sticks as $1, even though we only use 2 full glue sticks. But yeah, you can get this super cute wreath for under 10 bucks. So, in just a little bit of time, and it's fun. It's fun. So, oh, $9. But anyway, under $10 wreath. Super cute. I hope you guys enjoyed this. So let's get on to showing you what it looks like on the wall. Okay, so here is our little Easter wall so far. This love sign I found at the Dollar Tree. I found this cute little cross one that says blessed at the Dollar Tree. I found this little thing at the Dollar Tree. Bless this home. Then of course, our under $10 wreath. Look how stinking cute that is. And from standing here, I can see those little pops of crystals poking through. Oh, can you see that? Just that little pop of crystal that gives it a little bit more sparkle. Looks super cute. This here was also a Dollar Tree find. The other two signs were signs from a friend's wedding that were all handmade. This one says, as you wish. This one says, happily ever after. And of course, my half marathon medal for doing the half marathon this year. So yeah, here is my handmade and Dollar Tree wall kind of deal, decor. So I hope you guys liked this tutorial to make this beautiful wreath. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!